You have seen many, many tests for convergence in all those videos, and you may wonder which one to apply to your given series. Time for a short summary. Which test works best for which series? So, 1. First, look, do you know the series? Do you have a geometric series or a P-series? Then you're done straight away. Then 2, easy to apply, test for divergence. Look at what happens if the terms to go infinity. Go to infinity. If the terms do not tend to zero, you're done. And third thing to do, do you have an alternating series? First 3, you can see that straight away. Known series, terms not tending to zero, or alternating series. If that's not the case, then you have to apply one of the other tests. Well, if your terms behave like x to the power n or n factorial, then an plus 1 can be simplified and look like an. So in that case, the ratio test often works very well. If your an behaves like a p-series n to the power of p, for if you go very far away, then typically a limit comparison test will work very nicely. If your terms an look like fn to some power n, in that case, the root test can work. And if nothing else works, then your last result will be the integral test. So let's look just at the series. We won't do the test, but we will just look what test would be nice. So, example one is known series? No. Test for divergence, what happens if n tends to infinity? Oh, we already see that tends to 2 over 3. So test number 2 will work best. You already see terms will not tend to 0. Next one, example 2. It's not a known series. If n tends to infinity, terms go to 0. It's not alternating. So those 3 won't work. And what happens if n tends to infinity? Well, then the terms behave more or less like 2 over n. 1 over 2n. So they behave more or less like a p-series, so 5 limit comparison tests will probably work. 3, not a known series nor a geometric series, but you see already it's an alternating series. Test number 3 would work. Example 4, well, definitely not known. N to infinity, well, that's kind of difficult to see, not alternating. But you see power 2 to the power n powers, you see factorials, so typically for try the ratio test over here. 5. What do we have over here? Hey, wait a minute. We have 3 to the power n divided by 4 to the power n times 1 over 8. This seems to be a geometric series. Well, in disguise, but it is a geometric series. So we can just do 1. Next one. Oh, there we have a lot of rubbish to the power n. Definitely not known. Test for divergence will be kind of difficult, not alternating, but you see some function to the power n, so that will be 6, our root test. And then 7, you see terms tend to 0, it's not alternating and not known, but the terms behave like 1 over n squared, so here typically limit comparison test or comparison test would be fine. You may remember though that this example 7 is a telescoping series, so in this case you can even compute the sum. If you don't see it, you can still determine the convergence. And example 8, you recognize this one by now if you've seen my other videos. This is the one test which I got on my first calculus exam. I did all the tests and not one of the tests gave an answer, and I forgot the last resort. No test works on this one. Trust me, I did it on the exam. So for this one, you need your last resort, the integral test. So now you see, by really knowing which test you have, by knowing when they usually work, you can see very fast which test to apply. Of course, in an exam exercise, you can do all of them, but maybe you would like to try the one which works first. And that's what you hopefully learned from this short summary.